A warm welcome to everybody. I hope you are all doing very well. Children, if I say that we live in a very heavenly place, I think nobody will disagree. Because in our Uttara Kannada district, people will never die because of very high temperature, or people will never die because of very low temperature. Because in our district, the temperature never goes above 40 degrees Celsius and it never comes below 15 degrees Celsius. In the same way, we are very rarely bothered by the problems of floods and heavy rainfall, because the average rainfall that we get in a year is just 280 centimeters. So, we are living in a very heavenly place. But do all the people of India enjoy the same type of environment or same type of atmospheric condition? Are they as lucky as we do? Obviously, it is not like that. So, in our today's lesson, let us try to understand something about the climate of India. So, first, let us try to know what is the variation in the climatic conditions. So, if we take rainfall, Mausin Ram, if we take rainfall, children, here we have Mausin Ram in Meghalaya state. So, this Mausin Ram, it receives the highest rainfall, that is an average of 1080 centimeters in a year. And opposite to this, we have Rajasthan. And in Rajasthan, there is a place called Ruili in Jaisalmer district. It hardly receives an average of 8.3 centimeters of rainfall. You can just see the difference here, children. In the same way, if we take a temperature, if we take temperature, again, our Rajasthan's Ruili, our Rajasthan's Ganganagar in Rajasthan, it records the highest temperature, that is 49.4 degrees Celsius, whereas there is a place called Dras near Kargil. We all very well remember Kargil, because we cannot forget the bravery of our great soldiers in the war of 1999. So, it is near this Kargil, there is a place called Dras in Jammu and Kashmir. It records the lowest temperature, that is minus 60 degrees Celsius. Again, you can see the difference here. We have a place called Dras, which records the lowest temperature, which is minus 60 degree. And we have a place called Ganganagar in Rajasthan, which records the highest temperature, that is 49.4 degrees Celsius in a year. So, what factors influence the climatic conditions of India? That we have to learn in the next part of our lesson. So, let us try to know that. There are four important factors, children. First one is location of India. Okay. Then next one is water bodies. And third one is relief features. And fourth one is monsoon winds. First, let us understand how location influences the climatic condition of our nation. So, we all know that our nation is located in tropical zone and subtropical zone. What is this tropical and subtropical zone? So, let us know. Yes. So, you can see here, children, India is located here. Can you see? So, this is equator. India is located above the equator between 8.8 degree latitude to 37 degree latitude. That means India lies in the northern hemisphere between tropical and subtropical zone. So, what is this tropical zone? So, a region that comes between 23.5 degree south latitude, which is called Tropic of Capricorn, then 23.5 degree north latitude, which is called Tropic of Cancer. So, this region, the region between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn is called the tropical region. Our India lies in the northern hemisphere and Tropic of Cancer, you can see Tropic of Cancer here. This Tropic of Cancer, it divides India into two equal halves. So the South India, this South India lies completely in a tropical zone and North India lies in the subtropical zone. So you all know that the tropical region, it gets a vertical rays of sun, and that is why the temperature will be very high here. Not very high, temperature will be high here compared to other regions, temperate regions and polar regions, and the rainfall also will be very high. Okay, so this is how the location of India, the location, it influences the climatic condition of our nation. Then if we take second one, that is water bodies, how water bodies affect the climatic condition of a region, that let us try to understand. Again, let us come to the map of India. You can see here, children, this is our South India, and South India, it is covered by, it is surrounded by Arabian Sea in the west, Indian Ocean in the south, and Bay of Bengal in the east. Whereas our North India, it is almost landlocked. Here we have Pakistan, Afghanistan, China, then Nepal we have here. Here we have our Himalayan mountain range. So it is almost landlocked. Okay. So the climatic condition of South India is moderate, whereas the climatic condition of North India is a bit extreme. How it happens? Let us see. So, in your 8th standard, you might have learnt about the land breeze and sea breeze. Let us try to remember that. Okay. So, first of all, you should remember that wind always blows from high pressure area to low pressure area. What is high pressure area? High pressure area is an area with less temperature, and low pressure area is an area with high temperature. Okay. So, if there is high temperature, pressure will be low. And if there is less temperature, pressure will be high. Okay. So, wind always blows from high pressure area to low pressure area. So, let us imagine winter season. Okay. So, in winter season, what happens? When the sun rises, the land becomes hot faster than the water, right? You can take the example of dosa and coffee, a cup of coffee. Okay, dosa, it becomes hot very fast, whereas coffee, to get it hot, we need little time. So in the same way, when the sun rises, what happens? The temperature of the land increases very fast, whereas the temperature in the water region, that is your Arabian Sea and Bay of Bengal, and in Indian Ocean region, temperature will be very little bit less compared to land. Okay. So now temperature is less here over the sea, and that is why pressure will be low here. And here what pressure will be high here. So here when we are taking land body, okay, the temperature is high here, that is why the pressure is low. Okay, so that is why what happens in the morning session, means from 9 o'clock to 6 o'clock in the evening, what happens? This land area will be comparatively hot compared to sea, right? So the cold wind blows from this sea region to land region. This is called sea breeze. What is this called? Sea breeze. So that is why the temperature will become moderate, because cold wind is blowing towards land. Okay. Then what happens when the night comes? Okay. Land becomes, or land cools down faster, and the sea cools down slowly. Again, you can take the example of dosa and a cup of coffee. So if your mama serves you a dosa and a cup of coffee, dosa becomes cool, or dosa becomes cold in 2 to 3 minutes, whereas your coffee becomes cool within 10 minutes, right? So, this land becomes cool faster and sea becomes cool little slower. Okay. Now here land is enjoying low temperature, whereas sea is enjoying high temperature. Okay. Land has high pressure area and sea has low pressure area. Always our wind blows from high pressure area to low pressure area. Okay. So cold wind blows from land to sea. This is called land breeze. And what happens? Again, the temperature will be moderate. Okay. In the night also, it will not be very cold. And in the morning also, it will not be very hot. That is why in South India, people will never die because of very high temperature or very low temperature in the summer and in the winter respectively. So if we take here North India children, it is landlocked, right? So that is why land becomes hot very fast. There is no sea to cool down it in the morning when the sun rises and when there is a sun in the sky. Okay, that is why the temperature here will be high during day, and again when the night comes, the temperature will be very low. It becomes very low. So again in the winter season, if you take the example of Bengaluru and Delhi, okay, in Bengaluru the dew or the fall of fog will be very low within 8 o'clock. Okay, there will not be dew or there will not be fog. Whereas if we go to Delhi, there will be fog or there will be dew up to 10 o'clock, 10:30. Okay. Temperature goes above 40 degrees Celsius in Delhi and temperature comes below 7 degrees Celsius in Delhi again. That is why North India enjoys extreme climatic condition, whereas South India enjoys moderate climatic condition. In winter season, North India will be cool, and in winter season again, South India will be warmer compared to your North India. Okay, this is how your sea bodies or water bodies affect the climatic condition. Then let us take the third factor that which influences the climate of India, that is your relief features. By the word relief features, I mean the landforms. In India, we have different kinds of landforms, right? We have large plain here. We have very high mountain ranges, Himalayan mountain ranges. The highest mountain ranges of the world, it lies in our country, okay? We have Western Ghats, we have Plateau. Different kinds of relief features we have in our nation, okay? So, if we go to higher altitude, like your Kodachadri, Ooty, Mahabaleshwar, Shimla, okay. These places, they are located in higher altitude, means in the higher places. Here, temperature will be low, okay. So, then if you come to plain region, North Indian plain, it is warmer. Again, let me take another example, how relief features affect the climatic conditions. See here, we have Western Ghats, children. Okay. Here we have Western Ghats. Can you see the Western Ghats here? See, here we have Western Ghats, and India enjoys southwest monsoon winds which blow over Arabian Sea like this. Okay. Southwest monsoon winds, it blows over Arabian Sea, and it is obstructed by whom? The Western Ghats, which lies like this, okay, like a wall, and it obstructs the rain bearing winds and it gives heavy rainfall to this region, that is Western Coast. Whereas the eastern part of Western Ghats, it gets less rainfall. So this is how relief features affect or influence the climatic condition of our India. And last one is monsoon winds. Okay. So Indian climatic condition itself is called the tropical monsoon climate. Indian climate is called tropical monsoon climate. So we should know the meaning of the term monsoon. Actually, it is an Arabic word, and monsoon means mausam. Mausam means season. So how do we enjoy the seasons in India? We get rainfall in the month of June, July and August and September, right? So, Then afterwards winter comes, then afterwards summer comes. Again we will have the rainy season in the month of June, July, August and September in the next year. So this is called monsoon. Okay, monsoon winds, they come from southwest direction like this, and monsoon winds give rainfall to Indian people, and that is why the people of India are dependent upon what? The monsoon winds for agricultural activity. That is why Indian climate is called tropical monsoon climate, because it is influenced by monsoon winds, and India lies in which region? India lies in the tropical region. India lies in the tropical region, that is from Tropic of Capricorn to Tropic of Cancer, 23.5 degrees south to 23.5 degrees north. Okay, so these are the four important factors that influence the climatic condition of India. So first one is location, second one is water bodies, third one is your relief features, and fourth one is monsoon winds. Okay, now next one is, what are the different climatic seasons of India? So we have four different climatic conditions. We have four different climatic conditions. First one is the winter season. It will be there from the month of December to February. Then we have summer season, which is there in between March to May. And we have rainy season, and it will be there from June to mid-September. And after that we have retreating monsoon season, that is from mid-September to December. Okay, so these are the four seasons: winter, summer, rainy season, and the retreating monsoon season. First, let us try to understand about the winter season. Okay, so we have seen that in India, winter season will be there from the month of December to February. Okay, so why we will have the winter season in December, in the month of December? Why not in the month of June or March? Okay, so that we will understand. So we have two hemispheres, northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Okay, we have two hemispheres. The region above equator is called northern hemisphere, and the region below equator is called southern hemisphere. So earth has a tilted axis. Let me show you a diagram here. I have a rough diagram. I am very weak in drawing. Let us try to understand. See here, this is our sun. Okay, we'll name it, this is our sun, and the earth, it revolutes the sun. Earth, it rotates on its own axis, and it has got a tilted axis like this. Okay, so here you have equator, and here you have Tropic of Cancer, and here you have Tropic of Capricorn. So the region above equator is called the northern hemisphere, and the region below equator is called the southern hemisphere. And India lies here in the northern hemisphere, between 8 degree latitude north latitude to 37 degree north latitude. So here you can see, when earth is here, you can see here, children, the sun's rays, okay, see, this northern hemisphere, Tropic of Cancer, it is away from sun compared to your equator and compared to your Tropic of Capricorn. So in this diagram you can see, you can very well see, so Tropic of Capricorn, that is southern hemisphere, is nearer to sun, then equator is nearer, and then which is nearer? Tropic of Cancer. So this Tropic of Cancer, it divides India into two equal halves. Okay, so here, in when the earth is here, vertical rays of sun is there over southern hemisphere. That is why southern hemisphere is enjoying summer season, whereas we are northern hemisphere is comparatively far from the sun. That is why we are enjoying winter season. So this time comes when from December to February. So from December to February, during this time, our India, it receives oblique rays of sun, and that is why the temperature will be low here, and India enjoys what type of climate or what season? It enjoys winter season. Okay, because of oblique rays of sun over northern hemisphere, India enjoys winter season. Okay, what are the features of winter season? I have written few features here. First one is it will the temperature will be very less. Okay, so let us see here. The temperature will be less and humidity will also be less. How will be the sky? Sky will be clearer. Okay, then if we take the regions, okay, if we take North India and South India, I have explained that while explaining the water bodies, how water bodies influence the climatic condition. So North India is cooler, South India is warm. Okay, then January is the coldest month of India. In January we enjoy the coldest temperature. Then in the mountain regions like Himalayas and Kashmir, the temperature is very low. Then afterwards you can also see dew and fog. Okay, fall of dew and fog will be common. And then one more important point, India receives only 2% of annual rainfall. Okay, India receives only 2% of annual rainfall during winter season. So these are all the important features of winter season of India. So in the next part of the lesson, let us try to understand about the other seasons of India. Thank you.